and I'll just roll my sleeves up. I know he's a magician, but I'll just roll them up anyway, just in case you were suspicious. Again, more of an observation test than a magic trick. And what happens is you take one ball, it goes in this hand. Take the second ball. Again, it goes in this hand. Two balls. You can't get any simpler than this. I'm trying to be as easy as I can.
You start out slow.
Oh, absolutely, absolutely. Because you never know about these things. So, third ball, now this is where it really gets confusing. All I do is sweep. This ball hasn't gone anywhere yet, and there's a reason for that, because I didn't squeeze. Once I squeeze,
Wow, that was smooth.
Is this weird? Watch this. One ball in this hand, second ball in this hand, two balls. I can't get any more basic.
Right.
Third ball, again, watch me, because I'm really quite tricky. Third ball in my pocket.
Okay.
So that leaves me with how many balls? Oh, there's nothing new. Okay.
So there's two balls.
Absolutely right. Three balls. One, two. I just wanted to make sure you guys were paying attention.
Trying.
Right. One more time. One ball. Yes, sir. Thank you for your paying time. Second ball. Just two balls.
Yeah.
I, this is about as easy as I mean, you're got your Guns N' Roses shirt on, you're just... Third ball. This is the weird, really gets crazy. Third ball in my pocket. So again, that leaves me with... You gonna go with three?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go with two.
Yeah.
Actually, this trick is...
That's
him. Right. She said,
I haven't seen enough magicians.
Yeah.
Well, no, that's fine. I hope I can live up to this. Okay, so this is actually really quite easy to do because it just deals with two coins. I'll just get rid of this. No, it's really, but this is a 1922 piece coin.
Oh, wow.
Different magicians use different coins. As you know, I use a 22 piece. This is an old African coin. The only reason I use it is because they're contrasting colors, and you can see they're almost about the same size.
Yeah.
And it's an easy trick. I'm just going to push my sleeves up a little bit. Simple trick. I just want to make sure I got the trick down. So it's, it just deals with two coins. It's really easy to follow. Okay, so the way the trick works is I take one U.S. coin and I put it in my pocket. I think I snap. You know, hold on, let me just, I'm going to, no, I know you're disappointed, I just want to, I know this is really weird, I'm just trying to work the trick out, that's part of it. So, all right, you know what, I think it's the African coin, so, okay, so it is the African coin, so I take the African coin, put it in my pocket, I saw this one magician, it was doing like this. You know what, hold on, wait. I know, you're disappointed. You're probably saying, oh my God, he looks so good, but can he do the tricks?
I'm surprised how easy it is for you to start over.
Yeah. I just, hey, listen, you know, this is, I just want to ask you something, and I know we just met. These are, do these jeans make my back big? I'm sorry, okay, too personal. Two coins. So it is, in fact, I think it is the U.S. coin. Okay, so it's the U.S. coin. I take the U.S. coin. I just want to make sure I got it right. So that's the one in my pocket. You know, I know you're disappointed. You're probably saying, oh, my God. I think I got it. It's the African coin. So, the African coin. You know, I'll tell you something. The next time you guys come, I'm gonna really practice this trick, and I'm just gonna have it done. Quite a bit. I've traveled all over the world performing magic, and you see these guys, especially we live in, I don't know where you live, but I live in outside of DC. And you know, New York, Chicago, Philadelphia, these guys are always, they're on the streets. You see these con artists, they're there, they're doing all kinds of card games, and you see them, and I'm telling you, you can't win. I've tried. And I saw this one guy, I was in Kansas City, and he had what he called the money card. And I told him, I said, listen, I'm a magician. You're not going to be able to fool me. I know all of the moves. And he showed me three blank cards. I said, I know the moves. I'm hanging out with some of the top magic guys in the world. So he took a blank card and he put it on the table. And he took the money card and he put it right there in the middle. And I'm watching this guy. I told him I was a magician. He squared it up really slow. He took a blank card, put it on the bottom. Then he took a money card, put it on the bottom. Then he took a blank card, put it on the bottom. He spread the cards. He said, Mr. Magician, for $20. Where's the money card? I said, dude, what do you do? It's right there. He said, are you sure? It's the blank card. The money card's still on the table. So now, yeah, no, he had my $20. And I'm thinking, let's try this again. I was in shock. And so I said, listen, all right, one more time. Not a problem, he said. He showed me the blank cards. He took a money card, put it right there in the middle. I'm watching this guy like a hawk. He did it ever so slowly. He squared everything up. He took a blank card and put it on the bottom. He took a money card and put it on the bottom. He took a blank card and put it on the bottom. He squared it. He spread the cards. He said, Mr. Magician, where's the money card? I'm thinking, it's got to be there. He said, that's too bad. Because that's the blank card. The money card's still on the table. So now I'm out $40. I said, you know, one more time. He said, are you sure? I said, absolutely. He showed me the blank card. He took a blank card. He put it on the table. He took the money card right there in the middle. Again, slowly, squared everything up. He took a blank card. He put it on the bottom. He took the money card. He put it on the bottom. He took a blank card. He put it on the bottom. He spread the cards. He said, Mr. Magician, where's the money card? Now, he got me twice. I'm out $40. So I'm thinking, I'm going to
pay that one.
Yeah, that's where I'm going. He said, that's too bad because that's the blank card. He said, you should have picked the cards in my hand because that's the money card. That's the money card.
What?
And that's the money card.
Oh, man.
And that's the Kansas City Shuffle. And I am a member of what is called the Magic Circle in London. You may know about the Magic Circle.
Yes.
And so, to be a member of the Magic Circle, there's a whole thing you got to go through. But ultimately, what happens is you get one trick, and you have to perform it in front of 12 master magicians, and that's it. And if you don't pass that, you're not allowed to go back for another 5 years. So this is the trick that I did for them. This is, I'm just gonna show you, if you wouldn't mind inspecting it, just to make sure it is what it appears to be. And you can see that that's kind of empty. I just want to make sure. I'm just going to put it right here. And I have 4 Chinese coins. 1, 2, 3, and 4. But for the trick, we only need 3. And I'm going to give you these 3. If you would inspect them again, just to make sure that they are what they appear to be. The 4th one, I'm going to leave it right there. Leave it halfway chocolate so you can see that nothing sinister is going on. Yes, they haven't been compromised at all? Good. Would you thread them on for me?
Sure.
And what's your name, by the
way?
That's a good name. That used to be my name before the accident, but I don't want to get into it.
Well, I'm curious, though.
Thread them right through and put them in the middle because I don't want you guys saying later on when you get home, oh my God, I slipped it off somehow, it wasn't in the middle. Yes?
Yeah.
And you've checked everything, yes?
Yep.
So that it appears that all 3 are on. I just want to make sure. So, just make sure you got that. Yes?
Uh-huh.
2 left? Yes. Okay, so here's where it gets interesting. 3 coins, threaded on, you guys inspected everything. I know what you're saying at this point. My God, this man is good.
Yeah.
But you know what? The first one, I might have manipulated it somehow because I had my hands covered. But let's do this one opening.
Whoa.
Is that weird? You should see it from this side. It's completely different. One, and that looks like still on Omega's to look. Uh-huh. Yeah. All right. And so here's where it gets really crazy, because this one.
Oh.
Oh, was that too fast? Oh. My wife accuses me of that all the time. It's crazy.
Yeah.
No. I know what you're saying. It's just, all right. So let's try this. So let's do this. Let's get this over here. You know what? I want to try something else. So let's do this. We'll try that. Would you hold that for me?
Okay.
That's all right. And I'm going to take these two. So we've got two, and you've been handling these two the whole time, yes?
Yeah.
So would you hold on to these two and hold them really tight? I'm just soft hands. I don't have a dishwasher. So I hold on to those two, and I've got that. And that looks like it might still be on there, yes?
Yeah, I guess so.
I just want to make sure. So we'll try this. And if you don't mind holding on to this one, right? Just hold on to that. Yeah, oh, absolutely.
Okay.
So there's one, two, three.
Yeah.
Let's see what you have.
Wow. Did you feel that happen? Wait, no.
Did you feel the third one appear in your head?
Guys, my name is George Bradley. That is my comment.